YouTubers, it's me again, Renee. I found something very strange I would like you to see. Do your advantage with it. I hope you will. All right, so I will get started. This is an old battery, lead acid battery. I converted this one to lead alum, and I'm still learning it to get charge. It now sits with a charge of 12.60 volts. I drained it completely to zero several times already, and it's starting to build up power. That's what these kind of batteries do when you convert them to alum, and they won't break again. I explained this in a previous video. This is one of my first re-EMF chargers. It's a pulse charger. You will hear it in a second. What it does, it gives a pulse where it pushes amperage at about 12 volt, what the battery normally takes, and then gives another pulse about 50, 60 to 200 volts, also on the battery, but a very short pulse. And what this does, it desulfates batteries. So any lead-acid battery, you can desulfate with this charger and charge it. Just look it up, a re-EMF charger by Renee, that's me. This thing just works. This is another one. I don't know what I did with it, but it's broke, so I have to fix it. Okay, so what I found out was this. This is a car lamp. It's 12 volt, 4 amps. Here we have an amp clamp. I can show you what it does. Well, the voltage is dropping because it just stopped charging it. It's now at 12.57. Okay, I will show you something very weird. This lamp is hooked up, the ground is already hooked up. The positive is coupled to the multimeter, this one. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to load the lamp on the battery, and you will see the voltage drop on the multimeters, and these two differ 0.04 volts in measurement, which is negligible, it doesn't matter. Okay, so I will hook up the lamp now. Well, pretty bright. And you can see the voltage drops to 12.3735, still dropping. This one is another voltage, 12.27. You can see them both. It's pretty bright with the light. Now I'll switch on the amp meter and I will see how much on DC, how much, just reset it to zero, how much this lamp really uses up. And we're at 4.0203 amps. And let's see if you can see it. 398, it jumps around depending on the corner that you keep it. You know how these things work if you are into electronics like me. About 4 amps. It is drawing continuously, and it's about a 48 watt, 50 watt lamp, car lamp. So this is 4 amps drawing from this battery that I just converted. This is a very old battery that was completely dead, but I revived it with the re-EMF charger. I desulfated it, emptied the battery out, and put alum in it. And now it works again, as you can see, and I can deplete it completely to zero. The voltage is now at 12.87. And what I'm now going to do is I'm going to hook up the re-EMF charger as the lamp is running the battery. You can hear it buzzing and see the red lights that I put in there to see if the back EMF is working. Well, you can hear it. So this is working. It's inputting a voltage and a current into the battery as the battery is depleting. You saw how fast it was draining before. It's at 12.6 now and not dropping it anymore, or at least not as much. 12.6 and holding. Okay, let's see. The lamp is drawing. The lamp is drawing 3.96 amps. How much am I putting into the system? 1.37. So drawing 4 and putting in 1.37. That means that we're still drawing according to all the scientific data about 2.7 amps from the battery continuously. But the amp drop of the voltage drop is considerably lower now. So the input amperage isn't that high, but still the voltage drop stagnates tremendously. Lose contact, 12.7. Let's see what it does. Okay, measuring again. Putting the meter on. DC reset to 0. The lamp is drawing. I will just read it out because all the light is really blinding. The lamp is drawing 4.08. I am putting in 1.22. The lamp is drawing 4.13. Putting in 1.2. So putting in 1.2, drawing 4.4 amps, and the voltage is holding. Okay, some of you may know this, some of you may not, but if you know about the Tesla switch, that's another piece of technology, they explain how the ions in a battery flow work. My guesstimation is that the pulses that this one gives, the ReAMF charger, really sets off the ions in the liquids. The constant current draw that the lamp does is constant, there's nothing changing about that, but the battery takes a charge with a lesser amperage. And keeps charging, even though it's giving off power. And that's really strange. You see, the voltage really, 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 really holds. Still 12.4. And this one is 4 amps at 12 volts, so it's 48 watts. Continuously drop and drawing from this battery and holding at 12 volts. And what the ReAMF charger does, it inputs a voltage. The voltage matches itself to the battery. So what the battery needs is what the battery gets in voltage. And in the first pulse, it pushes amperage. And the amperage it pushes is 1.2 amps. You saw that. In the back EMF spike, it releases all the energy stored up in this coil back over this battery again with a much higher voltage, 50 to 200 volts. And I suppose that the whole chemistry of the battery just takes all that power and stores it, because I'm continuously drawing 48 to 50 watts and the voltage is holding. If this keeps holding like this, you can run this lamp, this 50 watts, weeks on, months on. Okay, maybe I'm doing something wrong. I just wanted to share this with you. I find this pretty cool. This battery is really getting stronger by the day. I charged and discharged it to 0 2 times now. And after 3-4 times, you really notice that these batteries, when they are converted to alum, get so incredibly strong. You see this one and that one still holding, using them for the grinders, for the drills, for whatever, and they function. 15-year-old batteries that just won't die. This one is very old too, but not as old, but it's getting stronger already. Okay, so Rene out here. I hope you enjoy this. If you have some comments or some ideas what is exactly happening with a system like this, just let me know. Just wanted to let you know what I found. All right. See ya. Bye bye.